seen it all. It can't all benefit to femme fatale. I can't fall in love with you. Seen it all. It can't all benefit to femme fatale. I can't. Hey, what's everybody? Thanks for stopping in. Today has actually been a long time. It's been a long time. Was one, two, three. It's a few weeks since we've, you know, face to face here. It's been a while. Things have happened. A lot of things have happened. Good, bad. You know, it's been a struggle. Yeah. School things, life things, medical things. Very, very medical things. A lot of updates coming. I didn't announce the winners in my last video. I didn't get on here and talk to you guys and announce those winners. But Julius was announced as the winner for the actual K669B, which that will be getting sent out to Julius. I did pick a few other people on the list to give stuff out to, pertaining to Rose, David Grimes. David Grimes was the only one who put in for the other contest, but you know, I'm only giving one mic out to per person. I'm not going to give multiple mics out to one person. David Grimes did win a contest for mine almost 2 years ago, but it would be wrong to go, hey, you won a contest a couple years back. I'm not going to give you a mic. Literally the only person who put in for it, but trying to give everybody an opportunity. So I have a few mics left. You guys let me know if I should do another giveaway or should I just start picking people to give it away to. But in, just in case I decide I want to just give it away to random people, jot your Instagram handle in the comments below. But anyways, that's besides the point. Today we're talking about the Phoenix Pro PTX-10. Phoenix Pro did send me out this. They are not sponsoring this video, but they did send it out to me for free. Thanks Phoenix Pro for sending this out to me. I appreciate it. All the views and opinions expressed in this video are my own. No one's coercing me to say anything. So let's go ahead and get into it and see what I think. So upon checking out the PTX-10, I really like it. It's very much different from the PRX-600. It's actually a lot smaller for one. You would, putting them up against each other, they are actually a class separate from each other. The PRX-600 is more on a larger scale professional for bigger projects. If you're really trying to do things specifically for yourself and on like a personal level, say for instance me talking to the camera, talking to you guys, the PTX-10 is exactly what I need for situations like this where I just want to talk to you and, you know, get my point across as quickly as possible without having to hook up all the bells and whistles and wires. The one thing I do like it is that it does plug in through USB. It does come with a USB brick that allows you to plug it into a wall and power it, or you can plug it directly into your computer and power it. It has an XLR quarter inch combo plug-in, and you can activate Phantom Power on it, which is pretty cool. I did test it with a Akai MPC-1, and I gotta say, it works fantastic. A lot of products I get, I test them, a lot of times I like them a whole lot. But since I don't use them right away, a lot of times I put them back in the box, and when I get ready to use it, I take it out of the box and use it again. Most everything I do like that, because I like to keep it put away, nice, neat, tucked away, you know, kind of thing. Some people aren't like that, just leave all their stuff out. Teach their own. Some stuff I do have sitting out. I have the Civellator USB mic sitting here on my desk right here. I'm not using it at the moment, but it's sitting on the desk. I do have the Fine mic that I use occasionally that sits on a desk, but that's in a box. I like keeping that one in a box until I get ready to use it with the MPC-1. But I was so impressed by the PTX-10 that I just left it on the desk. I didn't put it back in a box. I was like, no, this is staying out. Plug it into the computer. Plugged my Shure SM7B microphone into it, and upon realizing how cool it was, I noticed that there was a mic input that was separate from the actual XLR quarter inch combo, but actually it actually takes over that input if you use it. And it's a 3.5 millimeter input, and right next to it is a headphone jack input. And I was like, what? I was like, so you're telling me if I use this audio mixer, plug it in through USB, if I don't have like a regular quarter inch mic, XLR mic, I can still use a 3.5 millimeter input microphone with that input, and it'll just take over the first channel on the mixer. That's dope. And it leveled it up a couple more notches for me, because I'm like, well, I don't have to find some way to adapt, say, my Rode Video Micro if I decided I wanted to use that one day, or if I wanted to test out, you know, the DD4 Pro, something that has a 3.5 millimeter input, and I just wanted to use it and plug it into the computer and see how it sounded recording it into Adobe Audition. So that's pretty cool. I've never seen a mixer that does something like that, that has that type of connectivity in it, as well as the quarter inch and XLR too. So that was actually a positive in my book. It does have has four inputs. You got your XLR, you got your quarter inch inputs, you got your dual quarter inch output for your main, you got your headphone output that's quarter inch. You do have your volume control for your USB, so you can play stuff off your computer that you can hear through the USB port, through your headphones, and you have the volume control for that USB port. You do have echo control and echo level control. So I'm gonna mess with the echo, and I'm not really sure if you can hear it at the moment, but if you can, this is what it sounds like. But that's the echo control. I'm gonna turn it back off though. You got your 3-band graphic equalizer, and you got your fader volume control. Then you have your gain control that's right by your XLR input. And then you have your negative 20 dB button that just crushes your dB immediately. So you immediately lose negative 20 dB. But you can turn that back on, so you can quickly gain your decibels right back. So this is actually pretty nifty. It's not a whole lot to say about it, but I'm impressed. I'm greatly impressed. The fact that it works with the MPC One, I have a small enough audio mixer that works with the MPC One that I can carry with me with the MPC One, with my Shure mic, with my Shure SM7B or my SM58 or my Uhuru XM900, whichever XLR mic I want to take with me. I can use any XLR mic with it, any quarter inch mic I have, I can use with it. And I have a few minor controls to get the exact, you know, sound I want to hear for the moment. It's not going to be super, super professional. Does not have to be. I can still podcast. I can still go live stream. I can still game like this. It's perfect. Doesn't take up a lot of space on my desk. I can stick it over in the corner. It's right over off to the side over there right now. I am actually using the Shure SM7B, I do have the cloud lifter plugged in with fan and power activated for, you know, the extra negative plus 25 dB of gain or whatever. But I was also using it without the cloud lifter, and it still sounds really great. I'm not going to do a whole lot of testing with different mics and different things plugged in. That's not what I want to talk about. I just want to talk about how great the USB audio mixer is in its own. But they do have two packages. The package I got right here is the PTX-10A, which just comes with the mixer itself, the USB cable, and the USB brick to power it. They got the USB. They have the PTX-10B, which comes with headphones and a microphone. So if you're interested in getting headphones with it and a microphone, you might pick the PTX-10B. But anyways, I really like it. Compared to the PRX600, it's just as good in a smaller package for a single person. That's the best way I can put it. So if you're just one person that needs something solid to work with a lot of different things by yourself, with the option of adding like something other occasionally, this is perfect. But what makes it even better for me is that Akai released that 2.10 update, and I can use it as an audio interface with my MPC One and just make it rock. Just make it rock. It's lovely. Oh, it's just plus 10 for me. It's just plus 10. It sounds really good. The USB mics I use with the MPC One sound good on there, but this one, this thing with the Shure SM7B on the MPC One sounds 10 times better. But anyways, that's all I got to say, guys. And thank you for stopping by. I'll see you in the next video. This isn't it. I've got some more stuff. I don't want to do a whole... I don't want to overflood you with a lot of reviews. I got some other things I want to do, you know, for the rest of the year. I'll have some more reviews. Hopefully. Come closer. Hopefully. Some really nice camera gear will be showing up pretty soon. But it's just hopefully. No promises. Anyways, in my community tab, there's somewhere where I posted something about questions. If you see it, put a comment. Let me know what you think.
If I take you down, would you really hold me down and be your best friend? She just wanna hit me with a quickie by the pool, and I'm like, yes, ma'am.